12, 24, or 48 volts, what's the difference and why does it actually matter? Depending on the size of the system and the application that you're building, voltage is actually really important. And if you actually choose the wrong battery voltage, it can cost you a lot of extra money and cause you a lot of headaches. Thankfully, it's actually pretty simple stuff. Before we jump into the difference between the 12, 24, and 48, I'm gonna hit you guys with a super quick 60-second electricity lesson just to make sure everyone is on the same page and everyone understands what we're actually talking about. When it comes to electricity, there's three main things you need to understand in this video. That's volts, amps, and watts. It sounds confusing, but it's actually really simple. Imagine the water faucet on the outside of your house. Pressure in that faucet waiting to come out is like your volts. So imagine it's got 120 volts just sitting there waiting to come out. The thickness of the hose that you attach to that faucet and then run into your bucket is actually gonna be your amps. So if you have a really thin hose, you'll have less water going into your bucket. And if you have a really thick hose, you'll have more water going into your bucket. And the total amount of water that goes into your bucket is watts. And so the main thing to understand here is that volts times amps equals watts. And the main thing that you are gonna kind of hear us talking about in this video is basically if you take the faucet and you decrease the amount of pressure coming out of it, so it goes from 120 volts all the way down to 48 volts, you're gonna need a much thicker hose to get the same amount of water into that bucket. So when you apply that to real life, you're talking about wire gauges and having a much thicker gauge wire to deliver the same amount of watts to your inverter or whatever you're trying to power, as opposed to a much thinner gauge wire with a much higher voltage. Starting with 12 volt systems, these are the most common thing you're gonna find in like a car or a small trailer, RV, something like that. Should look very familiar to most people. Batteries like this are generally used for low wattage applications such as LED headlights on your car, running small fans, charging your phone and devices. And because the things that it's typically running in a car, for example, are really low wattage, you're able to run a really thin wire to all of these things, and you're able to have a bunch of wires running nicely, loomed up inside of your engine bay, and everything's very clean. When you start applying a small 12 volt battery like this to a solar setup though, you're typically wanting a higher wattage draw. So you're gonna wanna run something like a coffee maker, a fridge, lights and small appliances and stuff like that. And for a long time, 12 volts was the option when you were building systems like this. The problem is once you get to that like high wattage, for example, like 1500 watts, you're gonna need some pretty thick cables that can carry a lot of amps to be able to actually deliver that power to your inverter, to your devices and stuff like that. In saying that, it's gonna end up costing you a lot more money because the thicker a cable gauge is, the more money it costs. It also gets bulky because now you have multiple cables and they're all really thick, and it honestly just doesn't make a lot of sense. In our opinion, a 12 volt system is best suited for a smaller application, no more than like 1500 watts, something like a trolling motor, a small camper, trailer, or an extremely light off-grid setup. And thanks to the US Army during the Korean War, we have 24 volt batteries. When it comes to talking about the solar space, it probably didn't originate from the Korean War. It probably started from people taking the two 12 volt batteries they already had, connecting them together so they could use smaller wires to get the job done. You'll often see a 24 volt setup in like a medium size application, something like a RV, a small off-grid cabin, something that's got, needs a little bit more power than a 12 volt, but isn't a huge system overall. 24 volt system is a little weird though. The jump from 12 to 24 is kind of an awkward one. We would say 24 volts is good for anything up to about 3000 watts. Personally, I would just skip right over it. If you're not going for a 12 volt tiny system, we would say just go straight to 48. If you're looking at building a really any kind of solar kit, right now 48 volts is the standard. Whether you're building a small system or you're building quite a large system, I would still recommend you actually go with a 48 system. It just has so much versatility. Like you can really do anything with it. You can get an inverter as small as 3000 watts. You can get an inverter as big as 18,000 watts. And if you take a look at something like the EG4 LL batteries or the Life Power 4 batteries, you can get that same battery in a 12, 24 or 48 version. They're all the exact same thing. They're just wired a little bit differently. So why not just jump right to 48? 48 volts is gonna allow you to run the same load you would run on a 12 or 24 volt with a much smaller gauge wire because you need a lot less amps because the volts is much higher to make up for it. So you're able to just run a bigger, beefier system a lot more cleanly. You're gonna be spending a lot less money on wiring and you're able to have just like a massive output. These 48 volt batteries, you can get something like the EG4 wall mount. That thing's like a 14 kilowatt battery. 48 volts. The beauty of this is at the end of the day, if you buy, for example, one of those Life Power 4 batteries from EG4, you're getting the exact same thing, regardless of if it's 12, 24, or 48 volts. It's full of all the exact same little battery cells that are just wired together in a different configuration to give you a different voltage output. It's all the exact same stuff. So it's not like you're getting a sheer quality if you go with a 12 volt versus a 24 or 48. It's just your output potential kind of changes. Since you can use 48 volts to run barely anything, and you can use 48 volts to run almost everything, why not just go straight with 48 volts? So at the end of the day, that's not the most technical explanation, but hopefully it helps you guys understand the three different options, kind of what they should be used for, how you should just skip over the 24 volt option, and just give you guys a little bit more confidence when you're trying to understand what you're actually looking at. If you're currently trying to do any other research though, this video is in a small little playlist we put together of just educational content. If you're actively trying to like make a purchase and still need clarification, call someone like Shop Solar or Signature Solar. They have people there to just help you make decisions. We've mystery shopped both of them and they both did pretty well. So call them, ask them your questions, get some help. That is all we got for you guys. I'll catch you next time. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.